Well, hello everybody. Today I'm doing a video about the improved approval rating for AMLO since he did the since the situation with the raid. Oh, I thought I put AMLO in there. Huh, let me fix that. Okay. Anyway, it's AMLO's approved rating. And this gentleman, Chapucero, he is, I'm sure he's bilingual, but he doesn't usually do his channel in English, and I wanted to translate it because I think he said it really well. Kind of a little bit cheating, you know, because I'm using his info. But he did such a good job on it. I don't think I could better it. So I'm going to go ahead and just translate what he did, which I had planned on doing anyway, to let people know how AMLO is doing, you know, after the situation that happened in Culiacán, Sinaloa. And by the way, I have a lot of family in that area that would have been affected. And I personally feel that AMLO did the right thing. I would have hated to have had people injured in that area. And I think it's great that he was able to put down the machismo and be able to do the right thing, which is to take care of, make sure first that human lives are preserved. And that really, the only thing that Chapo was going to be was a feather in Trump's cap, because apparently the DEA was involved and they wanted Chapo's son, and it was a big deal, and it would have made Trump look good, but certainly it wouldn't have been good for Mexican people to lose their lives in order to make Trump look good. Especially since they seem to not really appreciate the Mexicans in the U.S. And the Latin people that have immigrated there. So I don't really feel like we need to do anything more for him. But in any case, it's still a good idea that he let him go, because in this way they were able to save a lot of lives. And things have gotten down to normal. I spoke to my family today and things are back to normal. But anyway, so let's go ahead and listen to, and I'm going to translate as he speaks, El Chapucero.
Los sucesos en Sinaloa han dejado un presidente más fortalecido popularmente.
So he says that what has happened in Sinaloa has left us with a more strengthened president.
Porque contrario a lo que piensan los conservadores,
because contrary to what the conservatives believe,
que esto es una derrota para el gobierno,
they thought that this was a loss for the government.
Demostró que el crimen organizado tiene más poder e influencia.
Because this demonstrated that the organized crime has more strength and influence than the government.
Que el gobierno federal,
the federal government.
Mexicanos, y en particular los sinaloenses,
but Mexicans, in particular the ones from Sinaloa,
opinan completamente lo contrario.
Have a totally different or contradictory opinion.
Opinan que esto que hizo el presidente, o sea, dejarle liberar al hijo del capo.
So their opinion is that this that the president did, which was to liberate the son of El Chapo,
finalmente revela, ¿no?, que la intención y la prioridad de
So what it reveals is that the priority and the intention
administración en particular el presidente
of this administration, in particular the president,
es precisamente lo que siempre ha dicho,
is precisely what he has always said,
paz, la armonía y la tranquilidad,
that he wanted peace, harmony and tranquility.
A pesar de que sabía que se le iba a venir todos los medios encima,
even though he knew that all the media was going to pounce him, even the international ones,
internacionales, la DEA, Estados Unidos,
the DEA, the USA, the FDA.
Y hasta Donald Trump,
And
ahora,
even Donald Trump was going to get on his case.
sí privilegió cuidar las vidas humanas de militares.
So he made it more of an important situation to take care of human lives.
También, claro, de las bandas,
Not
¿sí?
just of the people in the gangs and of his military.
En ese sentido, la mayoría de los mexicanos lo reconoce y hoy.
But in this sense, most Mexicans recognized it.
Hoy el presidente está más arriba en las encuestas. Hoy vamos a ver.
So now, in the polls, the president is actually elevated.
Muchas encuestas. Tiene rato que no hacemos un video de este tipo.
There's been a lot of questionnaires and polls.
Pero creo que es muy relevante.
But I think we haven't done this for a while, but I think it's very relevant.
Vamos a arrancar con una encuesta que se registró un poco antes del pasado jueves, cuando.
So we're going to start with a poll that started a little before the occurrence of what happened Thursday.
Finalmente se reveló el gran problema. Viernes, perdón. Fue esta. Aprobación de AMLO de.
So this was the approval rating as of from August to October had increased by 5% up to 80%.
Ha dejado aumentar de agosto a octubre, sube 5% y está por alcanzar el 80%. Esta fue una nota del 14 de octubre, que fue el pasado lunes.
So
Dije
that
que
was last Monday that they had done that.
presidente, según una encuesta de Encrol para LSR, que es la silla rota, se encontraba en.
So this was done by Encrol, by La Silla Rota, which found him to have 78 points.
Presidente en 78 puntos, ¿no? Al final, sí, el presidente arrancó bien, aunque tuvo una bajadita y ahora está teniendo una gran
So
subida de
he had a
5
little bit
puntos.
of
Está
elevation and then a little bit of a decrease.
más cercano al 80%.
But it was very near 80%.
Es por donde se le quiera ver, cifras insólitamente altas. Y
But
bien.
no matter how you look at it, that's actually very high numbers.
Viene el suceso de Culiacán. Y vamos a ver la nueva.
So then we have to see what happened in Culiacán.
Las encuestas, ¿no? Que ya registran esto para que vean que el presidente es más popular. Es increíble.
So this is what's happening in the questionnaires that they did in Sinaloa regarding his approval.
Increíble este fenómeno. Una de Massive Caller, la Política Regeneración, encuesta.
So this was a poll that was done by Regeneración, and they found his approval rating as such.
Pacificación de AMLO frente al narco. El pueblo lo apoya. Y ese
So
sí.
the people supported him. Approval was 64.8, 19.4 disapproved, and 15.8 had no opinion regarding it.
Un día después del suceso, recuerdan que Massive Caller
This happened one day after the occurrence on Thursday.
hace encuestas diarias telefónicas. ¿Usted aprueba o desaprueba el trabajo realizado por Obrador? 64.8% lo aprueba, contra 19.4% que no lo aprueba y
Yeah, so
15.8%
64.8
que no da una
approved.
opinión.
Wow.
Otra.
Here's another
En los
one.
últimos 3 sexenios, los presidentes han tenido estrategias diferentes para afrontar el problema del narco.
Okay, so it says in the past 3 6-year terms, the presidents have had different strategies for confronting the problem of narcotic trafficking. Which of the three strategies do you believe is the most adequate? And so let's see.
¿Cuál de las 3 estrategias cree usted es la más adecuada? 54.2% la de Obrador, que dice así: la estrategia del presidente Obrador.
Okay, so this one was the one from Obrador. He got the highest approval rating. 54%, 54.2 said that the strategy of President Obrador was the in order was to dialogue and to let's see. No.
Obrador, de dialogar, pedirles que se porten bien y no confrontarlos es la correcta.
And to ask them to behave well and not confront them was the correct one.
30% señalan que la estrategia de Felipe Calderón es la correcta, que la de enfrentar el narco con la fuerza del Estado usando al ejército.
And there was 30% that believed that using a Calderón's way, which was to confront the narcotic traffickers, using exercising any force necessary.
Esto contra los narcotraficantes. Y 15.6% opinan que la estrategia de Peña es la correcta, que...
And 15.6% believe that Peña Nieto's was the correct one.
Era la de negociar con los narcos para que no atentaran...
And that was to negotiate with the narcotics traffickers.
...atentaran contra los ciudadanos, ¿no?
So that they would not act antisocially towards the civilians.
Bueno, esto claro lo pone el encuestador, yo creo que...
So this was done by this inquest company.
No son así las cosas de las estrategias.
But we don't really believe this is the way things are.
Pero, bueno, finalmente es lo que pone. Ahora sí, como vemos...
But finally, that's what they showed.
Un día después de los sucesos de Culiacán, el presidente Obrador es el que, obviamente, está mucho más arriba que Calderón y que Peña Nieto.
So, even so... With the situation as it was, you can see that President Obrador was was seen as the best route, and then shortly followed by Calderón, and then Peña Nieto got even less than that.
Otra encuesta, Mitofsky. López Obrador, y esta fue una encuesta ya del sábado, cierra semana con aprobación al alza, ¿no? Miren, octubre dice.
So this one was done by Forbes magazine, and they said that at the end of the week, his approval rating had increased. Alza means increased. And so it says consultation by Mitofsky realized that AMLO tracking poll, which revealed an approval rating of the president that had increased. Wow, awesome.
19. Consulta Mitofsky realizó esta encuesta AMLO Tracking Poll y reveló que después de esto, Obrador sigue más popular, un poquito, pero más popular. O sea que, contrario a lo que pensaban los conservadores que se iba a desplomar.
So contrary to what the conservatives believed, that things were just going to fall apart.
Que iba a acabar como Piñera en Chile o como Lenin.
That he was going to wind up like Piñera in Chile or in
Moreno in Ecuador.
Moreno in Ecuador.
Como Jair Bolsonaro in Brazil.
Or like Jair Bolsonaro in Brazil.
Como Macri in Argentina, que se han desplomado.
Or Macri in Argentina that have had this terrible stuff going on.
Encuestas sacando las tanquetas y toda la cosa.
So that all the polls have showed that they're doing very badly.
Presidente, al contrario.
On the contrary, our president went upwards.
Consulta Mitofsky realizó una encuesta AMLO Tracking Poll, la cual revela que la aprobación del presidente cerró al alza la semana. Repito.
So this one says, this one that was done by Forbes says that he had increased approval rating by the end of the week.
Después de lo de Culiacán. La aprobación del mandatario fue de 63.6%, 3 puntos más que la medición del jueves 17 de octubre. Obrador, según Mitofsky, al alza. Hay una encuesta muy interesante ahora de El Imparcial, un periódico.
So this one was done, another inquest that's very interesting that was done by Imparcial, which is another newspaper.
Que hizo una encuesta por Facebook.
And they did a poll via Facebook.
Y bueno, según este periódico del Imparcial, 55% está de acuerdo en que haya liberado al hijo.
So 55% are in agreement that he should have liberated the son of Chapo in order to calm the situation in Culiacán.
Con tal de calmar la situación en Culiacán, y 45% señala que no está de acuerdo. Bueno, es una cita encuesta, pero creo que la que tiene, de todos modos,
But still, 45 said no, and it still shows that generally they agree with his how he decided to deal with it.
Respaldo popular, la mayoría. Y bueno, otra encuesta muy interesante es esta, que lo hace Carlos Olivares. No sé quién sea.
Now, this is a very interesting poll that was done by Carlos Olivares. And he had a poll.
Yeah, pero bueno, lo interesante es que en esta encuesta preguntan de Culiacán.
So this one they asked if they approve or disapprove to the violent acts lack of violent acts in Culiacán nationally. And this is nationally, he had a 46 approval, 54 disapproved. However,
¿Culichis se le llama? Creo que sí se les dice. ¿Usted aprueba o se aprueba el desempeño de Obrador respecto a los hechos violentos de ayer? Bueno, en lo nacional señala que 54% lo desaprueba y 46% lo aprueba. Pero lo interesante es este registro.
So the important part is this part right here. 72% of the people in Culiacán themselves thought he did the right thing.
72% de los que viven en Culiacán aprueban o aprobaron la liberación del capo detenido contra 28%.
So 72% approved him liberating el capo or chapo.
¿No? Ojo con el dato. Incluso aquí es otra pregunta. ¿Usted cree que hizo bien o hizo mal el gobierno del presidente liberar al hijo Ovidio? Bueno, en el nacional 42% dice que hizo bien, 58% dice que hizo mal. Pero a nivel de Culiacán, los que pues, viven ahí, 77%, una gigantesca mayoría.
So here, they're asking, do you think that he did correctly by liberating the son of Chapo?
Opino que hizo bien.
77% said that he did well in Culiacán.
Y bueno, eso me inspiró a hacer yo mi propia encuesta.
So he said, this inspired me to do my own poll.
Tengo mis redes sociales. Y ahí está. La de tweet.
And this one he did on his own Twitter account. See up there, Nacho Rodríguez el Chapucero.
La acaba de hacer hace algunos, como una media hora. Pero es clara la tendencia. ¿Estás de acuerdo o no que hayan liberado al hijo para evitar un baño de sangre?
So here they asked, are you in agreement that they liberated el Chapo in order to prevent a bloodbath in Culiacán?
71% de acuerdo.
71% were in agreement.
Están en el Twitter contra 29%.
And 29% were in disagreement.
La misma encuesta. 95%, claro, de...
Now, this was in Facebook. Now, of course, he says it's skewed a little bit because these are the people that follow him. But he said 95% approved and 5% disapproved.
De mis seguidores.
And these were of his followers.
Es evidente.
And he's got at least a million followers.
Tengo 45,000 seguidores. No, al final creo que es una buena muestra. Con 6,500 votos hasta el momento de hacer este video, ¿no? 95.
So this was only with 6,500 people that responded and voted, which was 95% approval.
5% están de acuerdo. 95%. YouTube, ¿no? Es donde tengo 1,000,000 de suscriptores.
So he has 1,000,000 subscribers on YouTube.
97%
on YouTube are in agreement.
Yo sé, claro, que el hecho
and
de
of
que
course, this is a little bit skewed,
sesgo,
but they are in agreement.
Esto me recuerda mucho esta encuesta que hice a cuando usted, porque...
So this, he says, this reminds him a lot of when he did a poll regarding the...
¿Va a votar por Obrador, por...
whether they were going to vote for Obrador or not.
En la campaña por mí, por Anaya y Obrador ganaba.
And that was in the campaign for him or for Anaya.
Con tanta contundencia. Me doy cuenta que este tema no ha polarizado. Al contrario, está uniendo un poco a los mexicanos.
So he realizes that instead of tearing the people apart, this matter actually united the Mexican people.
En torno a algo polémico, sí, pero que ha revelado que el presidente va a llegar hasta el límite en cumplir.
So this shows, what it actually shows, is that the president will take it to the limit in order to comply with what he has said he was going to do, which was to
La
maintain,
llamada pacificación del país.
to pacify the country.
Sea, el objetivo del presidente no es encarcelar a todos los capos del mundo.
So the objective of our president is not to jail all the chapos of the world,
No, o de desarticular y acabar con el narco. No, no. El
or to end narcotic trafficking.
objetivo, la estrategia de seguridad es pacificar al país. Y si pa
It's to pacify the country.
Ahora es necesario liberar a un capo detenido, lo va.
But if that is requires someone that isn't that was caught to be liberated in order to bring that safety, then that's what will happen.
Y es interesante cómo han reaccionado, ojo, los anti-AMLO.
So it's interesting to see how the people that are anti-AMLO have responded.
¿No? Vamos a ver algunos tweets de gente que
So let's take a look at some of the tweets from people that are against AMLO.
se declara que no es obradorista, que ni votó por él, que está en Trump.
That these people are against him and didn't vote for him and show to be against him at every opportunity.
Contra el Tren Maya y todo este rollo.
And they're against the Maya train and everything else.
Porque reconocen esto que hizo el presidente. Mira, Karina Velázquez.
Okay, so but they this is what they say regarding what the president did.
Que es una, incluso le refería a hace en unos videos, es alguien que incluso basta ampararse contra el Tren Maya, ¿no? Está bien. Cielo, el cártel de Sinaloa amenazó con masacrar familias de militares si no liberara a Ovidio. Antes de criticar a Obrador, pregunto, ¿qué hubieran hecho ustedes?
So here she wrote, this young lady who was against the Maya train and obviously has had a lot of, she's always been against AMLO. It's interesting to see what her question was, which is the cartel of Sinaloa threatened to massacre the families of military personnel in Sinaloa if they did not liberate Ovidio Guzman, which is El Chapo's son. And then before criticizing Obrador, I ask you this. What would you have done?
Otro tweet. Yo no soy simpatizante desde Salma 86. No sé quién sea, pero
So this guy, Salma 86, said, I am not a sympathizer with AMLO, with Obrador, but as a citizen of Culiacán, and due to the acts that occurred in the last few hours in the scene, that I am very grateful for the posture of the government, because I am hopeful that they don't have to live in their cities and feel afraid and impotent and not be able to take care of their families.
Pero bueno, no soy simpatizante del todo de Obrador, pero como
Very
ciudadano de
interesting.
Culiacán y por hechos ocurridos en las últimas horas, en serio agradezco la postura del gobierno. Espero no tengan que vivir esto en su ciudad y sentir miedo e impotencia por no poder cuidar a sus familias. Otro tuit, Horacio,
Here's another tweet.
totalmente de acuerdo, dices. Aunque no.
So this guy says, totally in agreement. But even though it is difficult for me to recognize that it was preferable not to do the error of the bad strategy and pessimism of the number of elements on the part of the government, there would have been a lot of civilians that were innocent dead. I am not a sympathizer with AMLO, but this time I am in agreement with his decision. Wow, nice.
Nos cuesta reconocerlo, fue preferible la liberación a que por error de mala estrategia y pésimo número de elementos por parte del gobierno hubiesen muerto civiles inocentes. Supongo que viene una conversación en donde están criticando la mala operación y ciertamente fue criticable. No soy simpatizante de AMLO, pero esta vez sí comparto su decisión, obviamente de liberar a Ovidio. Vamos al Face. Fabián Meg. Yo no soy simpatizante de Obrador, pero
Okay, so this guy says, I am not a sympathizer of AMLO, but I applaud the decision that he took with a cabinet, a security cabinet, and I applaud and back his decision. And it is not good to bend before organized crime and appear weak, but there have been many of lives that have been lost and risked, including those of the military, police, and the Marines, etc. Mexico lost a lot in the past and to organized crime, and now it was safeguarded, the security of the citizens of Culiacán.
Yeah,
I can see how they feel like that, because I feel the same way too.
Pero habiendo miles de vidas en riesgo, incluso las de los mismos militares, policías, marinos, etc., México perdió una vez más ante el crimen, pero ahora para salvaguardar la seguridad de los ciudadanos de Culiacán, ¿no? Y es que está comentando ante un mensaje de un militar que subió a una página que se llama Ejército Mexicano, en donde, bueno, señala este mensaje, ¿no? En que finalmente, o sea, es importante recordando que los militares son personas y también tienen familias.
So you have to remember that the military personnel are also people and they have families.
Y la amenaza de atentar contra las familias.
And the threat that they would go against the families of the military personnel was significant to them, especially.
Era muy grave. Ahorita por cierto.
And it was very grave.
Eran las familias de ahí de Sinaloa, han llegado más militares también allá a Culiacán, o sea, es algo que tal vez deberían haber hecho antes, pero bueno, ya lo están haciendo, pero no hay peligro.
So they are doing what they can. It's something that maybe should have done been done before, but they're doing what they can now.
Eso es. O no hubo muchas, o sea, hubo pocas relativamente, y no de inocentes, sino de manda con y alguno del ejército, un custodio por esto de la liberación de esos reos, etcétera, etcétera. Ahora, esos son, y estamos viendo acá, qué es lo que hoy, por cierto, para intentar contrarrestar esto, hoy publica Reforma lo completamente opuesto en una. Okay.
So, the encuesta Reforma, which is a newspaper that usually is against the president, they wrote absolutely the opposite. And they asked, do you believe that the strategy of the federal government against the trafficking crime was had a good, was well done, or was it a failure? And 56% said failure, 34% said that it did well.
Obviamente encuesta muy sesgada.
But you know, that one is also deviated.
Bueno, toda la encuesta, ya la estuve leyendo, la estuve revisando, es una serie de cosas, de sonceras, de sesgos estadísticos, ¿no? En donde lo que vemos, claro, aquí en Reforma, ni siquiera la voy a leer, porque ustedes ya saben de qué se trata. Quiere, obviamente, señalar que la mayoría de los mexicanos están en contra de lo que hizo, pero la verdad es que, y hablando hasta con la gente en la calle, con gente que no simpatiza a Obrador, que lo sigue criticando de una u otra manera.
So he says that the Reforma tried to say that that AMLO was not doing well. But actually, if you even talk to people on the street, people that don't even deal with this, they agreed with the behavior.
Que no está a favor del Tren Maya, está en contra de Santa Lucía, apoya Texcoco, pero de todos modos reconoce que en este punto particular, el presidente mostró algo que no había visto en otros demás presidentes.
So they recognized that in this particular point, the president showed something that none of the other presidents had ever showed before.
Its corazón.
His heart.
Sensibilidad humana.
Human sensitivity.
Y no solo huevos, porque lo que dice.
And not only testosterone or manliness.
Este Calderón, él tiene muchos ex.
Because they say Calderón, he had lots of testosterone.
Podrá tener los que sean o podrá no tener lo que le falta a Calderón y a Peña.
So he could have, and Peña Nieto could have, whatever they want.
Peña fue esto, seso y claro, corazón. Bueno, amigos y amigas, eso es todo por el día de hoy. Si te gustó esto.
Well, anyway, this is all for today. But anyway, I actually thought this was so excellent. I thought I wanted to. So, yes, give us a like, a thumbs up, subscribe. I'm on AMLOvision, and I have I'm trying to start a new channel called English AMLOvision, because I found that sometimes when I do Spanish shows, because I sometimes do Spanish-only shows, people in the English-speaking community complain because they don't understand. So, of course, I opened up another one, which is English AMLOvision. So I'm going to start putting my English translations onto English AMLOvision, because AMLO is not just for the English speakers, but it's also for the Spanish speakers. And there's a lot that they need to know, too. But anyway, so that's today's show. I do want to say that in the conference today, AMLO discussed a little bit about this, and I really am in agreement that he is keeping the people safe and opted against violence, and particularly because I have family that live in Culiacán, Sinaloa. My brother lives there, my aunts, my mother's mothers, and my sister's kids and all that. So I've got a lot of family that live in that area. And personally, I can tell you I am happy that he ended the war, because they were scared to even go outside. They couldn't go out to the market and get things they needed, as I spoke to them this morning. But I just wanted you to know, I'm very impressed with our president, and he is showing that you can get what you need by using peace. And let me tell you something else. Just because he let them go now doesn't mean they got away with it. Because they have a way of going later kind of discreetly and showing up and picking them up when there's not a bunch of hoopla, and hopefully nobody that will warn them. Anyway, that's it. Have a great day. Talk to you later. Bye.